Hi, and welcome to another IronTOF tutorial. My name is Julia, and today I would like to show you how to manage your samples on the sample holder in Surface Lab. In Surface Lab, full information about the measurement parameters, the sample holder, and other samples which have been on the holder at the same time are stored in every measurement. Furthermore, with the IronTOF photo box, a high-resolution photo of the sample holder is taken and ensures precise photo navigation in the instrument. There are two standard sample holders used in our TOFSIMS machines. The back mount holder retains all the samples behind a mask at the same height. The samples are held in place by means of spacer blocks and springs. The spacer blocks enable samples of varying thickness to be mounted in the holder. The top mount holder is used to handle samples that do not fit in the back mount holder, like very thick or large samples. The samples are held in place by means of one or more clamps that are fixed to the holder. After you have mounted your samples on the sample holder, open the app Prepare Sample Holder, which is installed together with Surface Lab. Load the sample holder info file, which belongs to the used sample holder, for example, backmount SHI. On your instrument, you will find one SHI file for each sample holder you have. It is highly recommended to keep this file always up to date, especially on a multi-user instrument. If you have a photo box, capture a picture of your sample holder. If you don't have a photo box, you will see the default image in the dialog. It might be necessary to calibrate the photo against the default image. Move the transparency slider to either select the default image or the photo of the sample holder. Specify two points with the marker. Suited points are as far as possible separated in both X and Y direction. For precise positioning, use the zoom slider. Repeat the steps with the second sample holder image by specifying the same points. For each sample area, you can now enter the respective sample information, which will be later automatically transferred into the header of each data file. To select the area, use either the drop-down box or simply click in the sample holder image onto the respective area. Do not forget to save the sample holder info file after you are finished and close the dialog. To use the automated navigation on top-mount sample holders, you must add a photo to the SHI file. The top-mount sample holder does not have distinct positions. Therefore, the user has to determine the sample areas. Press the Edit User Areas button to do so. Add new areas to the list and activate the area you like to specify. Then draw a sample area. If you use the polyline tool, a right mouse click at the end will close the area. You can select an area and move it around to correct mistakes. Then go back to the sample area screen and enter the sample information and sample heights to the respective areas. To use the top mount navigation, it is necessary to fill in a value for the maximum height of the sample. Make sure that the entered height is equal or higher than the actual sample height. The value can be updated later at any time to a more accurate number. In the measurement header, you will find the photo of the sample holder with details about the measurement positions, other samples on the holder, and so on. In the user entry section, you will find the information about the measured sample. I hope you learned something new today. My name is Julia. Thank you for watching and bye for now.